Good evening. Two women have been murdered, shot dead as they sat in a car at Revesby in our southwest, about to head out for their Saturday night. Our homicide commander says criminals have thrown the rule book out the window, breaking an unwritten law of not targeting women.
Gunned down on a Revesby street, 48-year-old mother Lametta Fadlala sitting in the back seat of a car outside her Hendy Avenue home when there was a knock on the window from the barrel of a gun, an attacker opening fire. A Saturday night ambush police claim to be targeting Fadlala, but hairdresser Amne Al-Hazouri, known as Amy to her friends, also in the back, caught up in the barrage of deadly fire.
Shots, it sounds like, and then you just hear a couple of cars speeding pretty quick down the street.
This is an organised, methodical, planned murder. It bears the hallmarks of an organised murder.
A 16-year-old girl and a 20-year-old man were also in the car.
They were just on been together on a social night out.
And as the attackers fled, so did they, around the corner to nearby Western Street, where they called for emergency help. The fight to save the two critically injured women playing out outside Peter Aiken's door.
They worked on those two women. It was amazing. Truly amazing.
Fadlala dead at the scene.
They put a flower on the lady.
38-year-old Amy Al-Hazouri taken to Liverpool Hospital, but couldn't be saved. As that played out, what investigators say could be a network of attackers left a calling card, torching cards on Presland Avenue in Revesby, a Mercedes on Devlin Drive in Wattle Grove, and another Mercedes on Elizabeth Crescent in Yagoona.
The flames probably came up past the telegraph poles.
The house actually shook. It was really, really loud, totally unexpected.
Police seizing security vision believed to show attackers in dark clothing, pouring petrol and making off.
Sources have told Nine News that Al-Hazouri and her young friends were only at this address to style the older woman's hair before a night out. As the group piled into the car, they had no idea what was to come.
The 16-year-old girl and the 20-year-old young man that were in the car with them, incredibly lucky that they weren't killed or seriously injured. They're devastated. They're assisting with inquiries, as if all the families that are linked to both the women that lost their lives today.
This afternoon, specialist police raiding the Hendy Avenue property. The investigation now spanning several suburbs. Lametta Fadlala is known to police. Detectives say she has criminal links, but right now, investigators haven't found a tie to recent gang war.
No evidence at all to suggest that it's part of any current conflict. We're going to treat this on its own merits. There used to be an unwritten law with the criminal element, especially in organised crime, that you don't touch family and you don't touch women. I think that rule of engagement and that law book's been thrown out the window.
Fears tonight of what this targeted assassination could spark.
Ruth Wynne Williams joins us now from Revesby. And Ruth, you have some fresh information on the investigation.
Georgie, 48-year-old Fadlala was the longtime girlfriend of Hilal Safi, the known standover man and drug dealer. He was found dead in January last year. Police are tonight probing that connection and links to other men in the criminal community. There is some speculation she may have had information that others may have wanted to silence. At the same time, Georgie, Amy's friends have told me she was bright, she was bubbly. They say the innocent hairdresser was just here to do her job, and she will be missed. Georgie.
Ruth Wynne Williams, thank you.